magazine must have just been there, or television, or something. But it's just interesting to see when I work with the Cave Collective, so we have Brandon Madley's newest fabrics and Philip Jacobs' newest ones. I do all his coloring for him, so I'm very interested to see his designs and use them. And then my own, and as they would come in, we would stack them up, and when they get toward the top, they would go up the stairs to the archive. Now, I designed a design wall, which is just a piece of flannel, and if you've been in the exhibition, you will have seen in the education room, there's a piece of these flannels on the wall so that people can just stick pieces of fabric up to it and create a quilt. And we do work on this. This whole room was filled with these flannel walls, and we were creating quilt designs earlier this week. And there's me finishing a quilt that's all just stuck on the wall. And what I would do when I'm finished with that is take a photograph of it so I know the layout, and then pick up the pieces carefully and send them off for somebody to sew. And you notice I always dress for the That's just rolls of paper from the internet. I think Google made it. But what's interesting is that it's just a nice design of a fish, and it reminds me that Brandon had a very, very popular design called Gone Fishing, and then followed up with this one called Shoal. That's his latest fishing design, and it's doing amazingly well. And there's somebody who just took a big sheet of it, surrounded it by Philip Jacobs shells, and we have a quilt. Voila. And there's some shells of mine done in needlepoint for the Ehrman catalog. I usually work in very smoldery, close tone colors, but here you can see I'm using some black and white, quite sharp design that comes from Australian snail shells. I love ribbons, and it's been nice to design my own, particularly when they're beautifully woven in France for the Renaissance ribbon company, and you can see the actual ribbons out in the shop. I've got them on my shirt too. It's very nice to line a shirt with ribbons, you know, just inside the cuffs and things. I've got a friend called Janet Hay. I've just written the introduction for this book where she's showing people how to work with these ribbons in the most creative way. And just lovely, lovely ideas in that book. And this is the quilt that got Liza and me together making quilts. When she said that she was able to buy this painting that I had done some years ago at one of my favorite periods of painting, I thought it's too good a moment, I've got to work with her. So I was very pleased to come and join her studio and really work on quilts after she got this painting. And that painting is in the exhibition. Now, this is Brandon and I going out to India. One of the things that got us really started was that Oxfam, which is a charity, asked Brandon and I to go out to the jungles of India where they did this beautiful hand weaving and create a line of fabrics that would be marketable in the West. And so I just knitted up this long rat's tail of stripes and sent it out to them and said, make some stripes that look like this in weaving. And so we got to the place and were trying to oversee them actually doing stripes. And these are the stripes that they're still doing. This is the newest range of stripes. Yes, that was all fabric. That's hand-woven cotton. Now, Brandon and I both love stripes, as you can see. I was just finishing up on my design wall, and Brandon walked by it in this mad t-shirt. And I thought, wait a minute. So we took his photograph and in front of it. I love stripes on stripes. That's another thing that excites me. And that's just the cover of a book I spotted somewhere, but it's so fresh and exciting. Wonderful idea. And there are stripes kind of twisting in corners. This is the S-block quilt. I did this in very tonal, in shades of yellow and brown when I first started. And then I noticed that people in my workshops were having much more fun just throwing lots of gypsy colors together. So I did another version based on my students' work. And it was really exciting. This is photographed in a village, a farming village in Bulgaria. And we did a nice book there called Cave Quilts Again, as if I'd ever stopped. Here's a little projects book we've just come out with, where you take, on the cover there, you can see I'm taking triangles of the stripes and created cushions. There's something similar to that in the exhibition. And when you take photographs, if you could turn your light off, that would be nice. Thanks. Now this was made by a friend of mine, and I just love it. Making more pointed, not squares, but wonderful diamond shapes out of the woven stripes and making them look smart as all get out. So I'm very, very pleased with that. It's wonderful what you can do with stripes. Now here's a very simple idea with stripes, where we just take making an enormous great weave out of big strong stripes, all in the cool tones. This is Liza working this out and photographing it in Morocco for Quilts in Morocco. So you can see how wonderful that carved doorway that's beautifully painted little flowers and things, just perfect setting for that quilt. And here's the quilt that's in the exhibition, which is taking, again, triangles of striped fabrics and creating these cross shapes in all different scales and sizes out of a series of stripes. And there in the border, you can see the series of stripes running around. When you go out and see it in the show, you'll see that those stripes in the border created all the crosses within, all the variations on crosses. And Brandon's Lazy Daisy is lining the quilt. I always like to put a good strong print on the backs of my quilts. Now, one of the things that's interesting is when I'm doing colorways, I'll just take little scraps of paper and I'll paint out new colors for a design. This is a design I've just done called Heraldic. And as I was doing these new colorways and putting them up, I also had on my wall a striped quilt that I was working out, and the two things just married together and almost came like camouflage. It was very exciting. I love that kind of thing when it happens. That's the quilt that I was working on. As I see, anything worth doing is worth overdoing. And I took every stripe that I could possibly find. Somebody gave me a wonderful big bundle of shirt stripings, and that all went into this piece. And there's some ancient stripes from the Venetian glass works in the Victoria and Albert Museum. Now, this is a piece of marbleized paper that somebody gave me, and I was noticing it when I studied it closely. It had these very, very fine stripes, and I thought that was incredibly attractive. So I just made a new stripe that is called Strada, and it's just based on that very fine striping. So there's another place where an idea comes from. This is the different colorways that stripe comes in. Now, I did a knit challenge that was great fun. What they said to me was, we'd love people to work with color, but you know, the poor dears, they can't really knit, you know, they can't really do Fair Isle, they can't do this, they can't do that. Oh, God, you know. 20 minutes to free to learn, remember? So I spoon-fed them a design that is all stripes, so you start out with two stitches and you increase each end of each row, and you create this design and then you decrease out the other end and you create a diagonal stripe without any sweat. And it was a great success, and people made all these different squares and sewed them together making afghans. And we had the jewel blues, and then we had rich reds, and then we had toasty browns, and of course we had to have something for the beige ladies. We don't want to scare the horses. Now, this is a wonderful work by my favorite artist in Africa called El Enatsui, and he just creates these huge tapestries of foil that he takes off wine bottles and wires them together and makes these amazing things. Some of them cover the whole side of a building, three or four stories high, so it's quite amazing. Isn't that rich? I first saw him in the London show, but I've seen him all over the world since, and most museums have a good piece of his. And they just, to me, he's the most exciting textile artist. He doesn't consider himself a textile artist. El Enatsui. And this is my answer to him, a little homage to him. I made a quilt taking every kind of golden fabric I had and sewing it together in these strips, and then putting a bit of color at the border. Now, one of the things I love doing is designing for the Peruvian Connection catalog. They send me this big flat box filled with the most beautiful colors in Pima cotton and alpaca. And I knit these swatches, and then they're made into garments. And it's just wonderful. It's very exciting because they have such beautiful, subtle colors. I'm always turned on by third world countries, particularly Africa and India, where they do the most amazing things with textiles. And this is little woven bands that are sewn together in Africa. And look at the way they filtered in color into that wonderful repetitive pattern. It's just so rich and stunning. And they're taking the same sort of palette, taking triangles of stripes from my stripe collection and creating the zigzag effect, which I call Rosita after Rosita Missoni, because one of the things about the Missoni family is when they design, they often use a zigzag pattern. It's kind of their trademark. And then in this exhibition, I have a lot of zigzaggy things that I put around that. There's zigzags done in wool for the Rowan knitting book. I'm always turned on when I just see something extraordinary in the street. And this is just a piece of street art that was just cropped up in the middle of London and then was gone the next time you turned around. But it was just wonderful, this kind of dynamic, contrasting, really strong, brilliant color. I just found it exciting and very stimulating. So I was just about to go off to Italy to photograph a book in Cinque Terre, and I was going to do things in kind of very husky Italian colors, but I used the dynamics from that to create the quilt. So there's my take on that street art, but in kind of more Italian colors. That will be coming out next year. Now, we were sitting in an exhibition in Germany, sipping our tea, as one does, and in walked this man in this sweater, and we said, and he stood in front of this quilt, and we went, wait a minute. This is too much of a good thing. So we said, you know, did your wife knit that for you? And he said, no, I knitted it myself. And he picked all the colors. Cheer. It was wonderful. And it was one of my designs that I'd forgotten about. I did ages ago. But it was lovely to see, and it made me think of a patchwork that I had done very similar